Editor Ning, what do you make out of the timing of this new local policy in Davao City? It's lodged about 7 months before the filing of certificate of candidacies for the 2025 midterm elections.
Well, it could be Bastet Duterte trying to hold on to a shred of charisma that he could get from his father. This is one of his father's cornerstone campaign promises during his run for the presidency. So I don't know if he sees that, if this will work for him as well. But I would advise him to remember that when he promised that he would get rid of drugs, he put a timeline. Yeah. And also he promised that when you get rid of drugs, we'll also get rid of criminality. He might have lost sight of that second part. And that is why people supported it, because there would be an impact, there would be a benefit to everybody. But I would also caution him that from my point of view, I would see this as an extension of the war on drugs from 2016. And although, actually even before the DDS killings, and although the ICC investigation only looks at killings from 2016 to 2019 when we were a member of the ICC, it does not preclude them at this time that they are investigating to look into fresh, quote-unquote, killings, current killings that are still being committed in the context of the situation. This is because the policy is important. If the policy remains in place and the killings continue, that is problematic for a situation. And in such case, clearly the ICC has to step in, because our government cannot do anything about the killings or even the issue of drugs itself. And so this would bolster an ICC investigation and prosecution, eventual trial, against those who might be held responsible for crimes against humanity.
Right, that was actually my next question on how this current development in Davao City would affect the ICC investigation. Does it bolster claims that the Dutertes are quite hell-bent on resorting to killing when it comes to their anti-drug stance?
I would say so. There is a direct connection between the Dutertes, their father and son, and father, son, daughter. And the family has had a consistent line and consistent approach in governance and as regards to the against drugs. So this would clearly link them to the allegations that they formulated, they created this Davao Death Squad, and that they are leading it. They are giving them incentives and are enabling the killings. Second, it connects to a clear policy. For Bastet Duterte to mention, quote-unquote, war on drugs, it already links his policy to that of his father's. So is this a continuation? And that is what the ICC will have to determine. And although, again, the jurisdiction is only between 2016 to 2019, because the killings continue, and because Bastet Duterte now is a politician, is a sitting mayor, the ICC would have to look at what was he doing from 2016 to 2019 and even before. So I believe this would only raise more questions, which the ICC will try to answer. They are trying to do a thorough investigation. And I'm pretty sure that they would have to look into this new issue of the pronouncement of a new war on drugs on the Davao front.
Will it be fair to say that Mayor Bastet Duterte has placed his family in more trouble? Or is that a null argument, considering that the Marcos Jr. administration is quite keen on not allowing ICC investigators to come to the Philippines?
I don't know about more trouble. I mean, from what he has already cost the family, but certainly trouble in the sense that he's digging the graves deeper in this ICC investigation. It's giving them, this is fodder for the ICC to feed on. Any information that is relevant to the situation in the Philippines will have to be reported to the ICC. The investigation, I think, will have to look into the current administration, even if the killings that have happened might not fall under the framework. The continuation of the war on drugs is a policy issue. And that is going to be an issue as well with the current president, who has declared that he has a different approach. So So as regards to Duterte's versus the Marcoses, I think this is the comparatively worse trouble than with the ICC, because the ICC is already investigating his father. Obviously, there might be traces to him as well. But in this direct attack, so-called, against the Marcos policy, then I guess this will be Mayor Basay defending himself against the president.
All right, Attorney Conti, 7 people killed in that local drug war, but are there actually families or kin of these victims who are filing cases, or are they just simply kowtowing to these acts of violence?
To be candid, Katrina, we have not interviewed any of the families in Davao as yet. We are working on the ground. There are lawyers who are there, but it appears that there is a sense of fear instilled in the city of Davao, and some sort of pride even in the peace and order in the area. We are waiting for the families to come forward, and there have been several from Mindanao from the 2016 to 2019 era. But for this fresh killings, it might take time for the families to process what happened. I would advise these families to carefully look at the documents that they will be provided to ensure that these documents accurately reflect what happened. I'm looking at pictures and videos of alleged evidence, but to note, when a person is killed in the course of a police operation, say for example, the police operation is for a by-bust.
It seems that we have lost the line linked to Attorney Cristina Conti. She is the ICC Assistant to Counsel here in the Philippines, and we will try to bring her back in our succeeding programs.